Our colony moved in their new home successfully. We have hundreds of workers, and the bigger major workers also appeared already. This colony is mature already. In the nest part, we can observe perfectly the organization of the ant colony. The queen and the eggs are in the middle of the nest, in a well-protected place. It's a moist chamber, near the sponge. Larvae are on the next floor, still in a moist chamber. Finally, the pupae are higher up, in a warm, dry chamber. The new workers are also born here. The workers are organizing the brood continuously and feeding the larvae. In this way, they can ensure that the colony can work in a well-organized manner. In the lower left chamber, we can see remains of insects, and this chamber is also much dirtier than all the others. Ants often create litter chambers inside the nest, where they can deposit their waste without having to venture out into the dangerous world outside. Since this chamber is away from the humidifying sponge, it is great for this purpose. Another trash chamber can be seen in a later shot from the colony a few weeks later. Here, in the middle, the ants pack the remains of the hatched pupae to the top floor. Species recommended for beginners don't require any special care. Our most important tasks are feeding, watering and cleaning. The ant society does all the other tasks instead of us. Let's start with feeding and watering. Need to water the moisture sponge regularly with a syringe. It is also recommended to put a test tube setup or other external watering inside the formicarium for the colony. From these, they have plenty of access to drinking water, and this can also be a kind of guarantee in case of a water shortage. Feed them at least once a week. Some species must feed on seeds, but most species only eat sugar or honey and insects. Before starting to keep them, always find out about the needs of the given species. We can also give them food in small cups or bowls, which makes it easier to take out the leftovers and makes feeding less messy. Over time, the colony will cover the honey with whatever debris they can get their hands on. This is a protective instinct in ants. In nature, this is how they prevent liquids from flooding them or their mates from getting stuck into it. We can still give the insects cut up, but since we already have a mature colony, we can also give them live food if we are sure that they can handle it and that it doesn't dangerous to them. This formicarium has a big airspace and is well ventilated, so the formic acid used for defense won't be dangerous to themselves. It's always exciting to watch how the ants fight with their prey. Each species fights differently. Some species use their stings, others spray formic acid. Some species hunt alone, others fight in groups. After eating, they share the food with their sisters. We can observe that the risky outward tasks like hunting, foraging and collecting are usually performed by older, possibly injured workers. They are the expendable individuals in the colony, while the younger ones do safer jobs inside the colony. Cleaning. Acrylic formicariums are easy to clean. Insect remains can be removed from the arena with tweezers. And we can wash off the remains of the honey with tweezers and a wet piece of cotton. If we feed in a bowl, it can also be easily removed with tweezers. In addition to feeding and cleaning, we also have to pay attention to the ideal temperature. And species that live further from the equator, such as domestic ones, require hibernation during the winter, while tropical ant species don't need this, but it's recommended to heat them from time to time. I will talk more about this in the next video. Click for the next episode.